and you let it solidify for a few days, 7 days, 8 days, whatever. And then you take the wooden frame out. What you get is a pillar. What you get is a short concrete column. Hello everyone, this is Manas, your friend and tutor. And guys, in today's session, we'll solve two problems from statically indeterminate systems. Both of them are going to be awesome, and it is going to really develop your skills on mechanics of solids. Now, before we get started with the video, let me just show you the path as to where this lecture series on MOS is actually approaching. Now, today precisely is the last video in simple stresses and strains. After this, that is from tomorrow, I'm going to start off with thermal stresses. That is going to be also a very important aspect for both civil as well as mechanical engineers. If you have to take this course, thermal stresses, well, it's going to play a very, very important role. So do watch it. And for all the aspirants who are watching my videos, aspirants from GATE examination, from engineering services examination, once this finishes, once the topic of thermal stresses get over, I mean, there are going to be 3 to 4 lectures at the most. The final lecture is going to be a combo of simple stresses and strain, and also thermal stresses, where I've planned 30 to 40 objective problems from previous years GATE examinations, from engineering services examination, and all of them will be solved in this classroom. So there is a lot of things on offer. It's time for you to subscribe to the channel, and if you haven't, well, go ahead and subscribe it. So let's start off with today's session, and here is problem number one at the top of your screen. Here we go. So there is a load of 2 MN which is applied on a short concrete column. Now this concrete column is 500 by 500. The cross section is 500 by 500. Let me just write this. Now guys, the load applied is 2 MN. Mega is 10^6, so 2 × 10^6 MN. Now there is this concrete column, the cross section, well, it is 500 by 500. Okay, now this is millimeters. And also we have steel bars. It is reinforced by steel bars. How many? Well, let me just see. The number of steel bars is 4 steel bars. Okay, 10 millimeter diameter. 4 steel bars. Steel bars is 10 millimeter dia, and the quantity is 4. Anything else? So we've got also got the Young's modulus for both steel rods, steel bars, and concrete. So obviously, concrete will break earlier than steel rod, right? And that's why it has a lesser value of Young's modulus. You can clearly see over there, the concrete's Young's modulus is 1.4 × 10^4, whereas in case of steel, it is 2.1 × 10^5. Let us just write that. For steel, I'll put a subscript S over here. This is 2.1 × 10^5 Newton per millimeter square. Now, this problem will be entirely solved considering Newton and millimeter. So make sure you convert everything in millimeters. And also the Young's modulus for concrete has been given as 1.4 × 10^4, okay, Newton per mm square. So all these data have been given to us. Now some of you guys might be wondering as to how does a short concrete column look like. So let me just show you. Just watch. These are the bars, okay, 4 steel bars, the red colored bars. Now what we usually do is, you have 4 wooden frames, okay, across this. Let me just show you how does it look. If you have 4 wooden frames like this, and when you pour in concrete inside this, okay, see the blue color. When you pour concrete inside this entire arrangement, and you let it solidify for a few days, 7 days, 8 days, whatever, and then you take the wooden frame out, what you get is a pillar. What you get is a short concrete column, which is being reinforced by 4 steel bars, just to strengthen it up, you know. Okay, that's it. And above it, there is a load of how much? 2 MN. Now guys, one thing is for sure, that this load is going to be shared by the 4 steel bars and also the concrete. Now it becomes very important for us to know the cross section area of every steel bar and to know the cross section area of the concrete also. So when you take a look at this from the top, when you take a look at this arrangement from the top, how would it look? Just watch over here. How would it look? It would look something like this. Now what we want is the cross section area of any one steel bar, let's say. How can that be achieved? Well, it's going to be AS is equal to pi by 4 times of d square. Pi by 4 d square, d is how much? 10 millimeters. Once you do this, 100 by 4 is 25. This is going to be equal to 25 pi millimeter square. Now, the unshaded portion is concrete. Whereas the shaded portion is the steel bar, isn't it? What we wish to find is this unshaded portion, that is area for concrete, AC. Well, it is going to be equal to, just watch, 500 multiplied by 500, that is the total area of the square, minus the area of these four steel rods, this cross section area, minus 4 times of this, 25 pi. So once you do this calculation, the value of area of the concrete, well, it is going to work out as, let me just see, I have already done that calculation. This is precisely 249685.8 millimeter square. That's it. Okay, now watch again. This is going to be very interesting. The total load over this is 2 megaNewtons. That load is going to be shared by these four steel bars. Okay, so I can write this as 2 × 10⁶ is equal to load shared by 4 steel bars. So load shared by steel bar is PS. For 4 steel bars, we are going to have 4 PS plus the load on concrete. So this is going to be your equation number 1. What we are supposed to find is the stresses in concrete and steel bars. So what we are supposed to find is stresses in concrete. Let me just, instead of writing it over here, this is what is supposed to be found. Sigma C and sigma n's. That is something that we need to work out. So can we do that? Now this is going to be fairly easy. Let me just tell you, 2 × 10⁶ is equal to 4 times of sigma s dot as plus sigma c dot ac. As simple, you just need to punch in the value of as and ac, you'll have an entire equation in sigma s and sigma c. So here it is. So this is exactly how the first equation has been framed. Let me just write 1 over here, equation number 1. And there are 2 unknowns, sigma s and sigma c. For 2 unknowns, we need to have 2 equations. Equation 1, well, that's already known to us. We need to frame another equation. How can that equation be worked out? Now guys, watch. The compression in steel rod, in any one steel rod, compression in any steel bar will be equal to the compression in concrete, isn't it? And with this philosophy, we are actually going to again develop a relationship between sigma s and sigma c. So watch this. This is going to be very interesting. Compression in steel bar. This is PL over AE. PS, LS over AS, ES is equal to PC, LC, AC over EC. Now there is one substitution that I would like to make. And that is, in place of this P over A, you can write sigma. And here also, P over A, you can write sigma. So this is going to become sigma S multiplied by LS. Now guys, watch this. LS and LC, it's one single column. There we have concrete. The length of the concrete is equal to the length of the steel bar. These two things cancel out. So what you do have is sigma S is equal to, this is going to be sigma C multiplied by ES over EC. If you just try to do a calculation, ES over EC, what is ES? That is 2.1 over EC 1.4. So 7, 2 is 14, 7, 3 is 21. Okay, so 3 by 2. 3 by 2, 10 power 4, 10 power 5. Only 110 remains in the numerator. So 3 by 2 into 10. That means 3 by 2 is 1.5, 1.5 into 10 is 15. So we now know that the stress induced in steel, will be 15 times that of stress induced in concrete. Now we have the second equation. Now this becomes very easy. Now you just need to punch in the value of sigma s is equal to 15 times sigma c over here. In this single equation, there is going to be then only one unknown, that is sigma c, and based on that equation you can calculate it very, very easily. Let me go ahead and tell you how this can be done in a calculator. So we've got two equations. Let me just try to frame those in a better fashion. Let me just show you. Let's try to do this in a calculator. Here we go. Sigma S and sigma C. So the first equation is like this. Sigma S minus 15 sigma C is equal to 0. Let's say this is our equation number 1. And the another equation which we have is this. 25 into 4 is 100, 100 pi. 100 pi, pi is 3.14. That is 314. 314 sigma S. And plus 249685 sigma C and is equal to 2 into 10 raised to 6 newtons, and that is our equation number 2. Let's try to solve these two equations with the help of a scientific calculator. Let me just show you. So guys, watch this. So we've got two equations. Let me just go to mode, and for equation we have 5, then ax plus by is equal to c, 1, and at the value of a, 1 minus 15 and 0, a, b, c, 1 minus 15 and 0. And then again, for second equation, the value of a is 314 and b is 249685.8. Let me just 9685.8, and then over to the right hand side we have this 2 mega newtons. So 2 1 2 3 4 5 6, and there you go. Once you punch all of this, press enter again, and you're going to have the final value of x. X is nothing but sigma s, and y is going to be sigma c. Let me just check. X is going to work out as 117.92. let me write it over here. From the calculator, sigma s 117.92 newton per mm square, and the second value, that is sigma c for concrete, well, that is going to work out as, press enter once again, 7.86, isn't it? 7.86, I got 7.85, okay, 7.86 newton per mm square. Now, after watching this video, I am very much sure that you must have got a good idea as to how equations are framed and how can they be easily solved with the help of a calculator. You could have simply punched the value of sigma s is equal to 15 times of sigma c into this equation also. This will become then one equation, one variable problem. It's very easy. Anyway, let's not talk about math. Let us talk about the second problem. Alright, let me just go through the problem. There are two vertical rods, one of steel and other of copper. Two vertical rods, okay, rigidly fixed at the top and are 50 centimeters apart. So, given data, how many rods are there? There are two vertical rods. So, the arrangement is something like this. One rod is of steel while the other is of copper, okay, and both of them are separated by some distance, that is, I guess, 50 millimeters. Okay, like this, and then there is a crossbar. Yeah, this, let me just read that once again. Both of them are 50 centimeter apart, one is steel, other is copper. So this one, let's say, well, these are steel bars, so obviously the cross section is going to be circular, and their diameters also must have been given to us. So this right over here is a steel bar and this is copper. Okay, what else? Diameter and length of each rod. So the diameter is common and also the length is also common. So the diameter is steel is, and the length of steel, the diameter of copper and the length of copper, both of them, well, they are same. How much that value has been given as 2 centimeter and 4 meter. 2 centimeter. And this is 4 meter, same, 2 centimeter and 4 meter. Anything else? The crossbar fixed to the rod at lower end carries a load of 5000 newtons, okay, such that the crossbar remains horizontal. Now, onto this crossbar, guys, this is a crossbar, by the way, crossbar, which is being supported by these two rods, you can say, or this crossbar is suspended at the lower end of these two rods.
Now there is a load of 5000 newtons, right? Find the stresses in each rod and the position of load on the bar.
The load of 5000 is put up in such a manner that this bar always remains horizontal. You have to make sure that happens. Let's say that the load is applied right here. Let's say here we apply a load of 5000 newtons at a distance of x meters away from this. Let's say this is end point B and this is end point A, or from this copper rod at a distance of x meters away from to the left, we have applied a load of 5000 newtons. We wish to find this x also, for which this crossbar will remain horizontal. And secondly, we also need to work out the stress induced in the steel rod and the stress induced in this copper rod. Let me just write. And anything else which has been given, steel and copper? Well, Young's moduli has been given. ES has been given as 2 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. And E copper has been given as 1 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per mm square. Anything.
Okay. So what to do now? What to do?
That steel, that copper. If this remains horizontal, just listen to what I have to say. This crossbar always remains horizontal. Why? Because this load of 5000 Newton has been applied in such a manner at a particular distance x away from this end B, you can say. Okay. If this always remains horizontal, then the extension in steel will be equal to the extension in copper, isn't it? Extension in steel will be equal to the extension in copper. So let us just write that. Extension in steel is going to be equal to the extension in copper. So based on that philosophy, what you can do is, you know that extension is PL over AE. Instead of writing this P over A, what you can substitute is sigma. So it is going to be sigma L over E. Sigma S LS over ES is going to be equal to sigma C LC over EC. You can clearly see LS and LC, both of them are equal. Therefore, it's going to cancel out. No point. Sigma S. Well, sigma S can be worked out as sigma C times ES over EC. And what is ES? ES is 2 into 10 raised to 5. This is 1 into 10 raised to 5. This over this. 2 by 1. Obviously, this is 2. Now, we have an expression sigma C. Not sigma C over here. Let's have sigma S. Stress induced in case of steel will be equal to 2 times of the stress in case of copper. Let's say this is our equation number 1. How to frame another equation? Well, that equation can be framed by considering, let me just do it over here. FBD of crossbar. Let us draw the FBD of crossbar. The crossbar always remains horizontal. Okay, here copper and here steel, and the distance between these two is 50 centimeters. So in millimeters this is going to be 500 mm, isn't it? Now then there is this load over here. How much? This is 5000 newtons at a distance of, this is x, this is point A, this is point B. If this remains horizontal forever and ever, then what we can write is moment about any point on the plane, let's say point B, is equal to what? Moment about point B, that is this point, the moment is going to be zero. So watch here, 5000, okay, here and here, anti-clockwise moment. So 5000 multiplied by x, anti-clockwise is positive, plus 5000x, what else? So the moment of PC cannot be taken into the picture because it is passing through the point B, which is actually the point about which moment is being taken, right? Its moment will be zero. What about PS? PS, clockwise moment. The force is PS and the distance is 500. So 500 PS, clockwise minus 500 PS. You just need to solve this equation, and once you do that, x is going to be equal to, watch, this is going to be PS upon, this is going to be 10. Let's say this is our equation number
2, right? But we want to find the value of sigma s and sigma c. How can that be done now? Now guys, watch this. This is the load applied, 5000 newton in the downward direction. This load is going to be shared. Some part of it will be shared by the steel rod and some part of it will be shared by the copper rod. So you can also say that total load shared by steel is PS, and this is going to be PC for copper. This is going to be equal to 5000 newtons, isn't it? This can also be represented in a better fashion. We can also write this as sigma S AS plus sigma C AC is equal to 5000. Okay, what else can we do? You can put the value of AS and AC over here. And AS and AC, by the way, both of them are going to be same. So what you can do is sigma S plus sigma C, AS and AC. Area can be taken. Since the diameter is same, therefore the area is also going to be same. How much is the area? Pi by 4 times of D square. How much is D? 2 centimeters. That means 20 millimeters. 20 square is equal to 5000. You just have got to solve this equation, and this is going to be very, very easy. Sigma S plus sigma C will work out as 5000 into 4 divided by pi times of 20 square. Let me just do this small calculation. 5000 into 4 into 4 divided by pi times of 20 square, and this is will work out as 15.91915. Let us take it as 15.92. sigma s 15.92. Let's say instead of calling this as equation 3, let's say this is equation number 3. Solving 1 and 3. Let me just show you. So sigma s 15.92, right? Mod 5111 and 15.92. Another, this sigma s, well, this can be framed in a better fashion. Let me just show you. This can also be written as sigma s minus 2 times of sigma c is equal to 0. Let's do that. So the coefficients are 1, minus 2 and 0. Isn't it? 1, minus 2 and 0. 1, minus 2 and 0. So on solving, this is what we are going to get. X will be 796 upon 75. What is that? 10.61. Let me just see. Sigma S is working out as 10.61 and sigma C will be 5.3. 10.61 and 5.3. Both of them are in Newton per mm square, Newton per mm square. This is sigma C, that is for copper. So these are the two values which we've got. One more thing which we need to have is this PS. So this can also be calculated fairly easy. Now, if you watch, PS can be written as sigma S into AS whole divided by 10. What is sigma S? You already have the value, 10.61. 10.61 multiplied by area. Area is pi by 4 D squared. Diameter is 2 centimeters. That is 20 millimeters. All of this divided by 10. You do this calculation and the value of X which you are going to get is 333.3 millimeters, or you can also say 33.3 centimeters. That's it. So guys, that was all for today, and in the next video we are going to take a look at thermal stresses and strains. So again, thanks for watching. Have a nice day.